Hello everyone, my name is Navneet Kaur and today I will demonstrate to you about Yelo marketplace for laundry use case. So currently we are on an admin dashboard panel wherein we can see different heads like customers, laundry stores, notification and orders. So under customers we can see that two customers have signed up today and there are total number of 8 customers. Under laundry stores we can see that we have total 4 laundry stores present on the platform. And under orders, we can see that 7 orders are cancelled, 3 are pending, and 0 order is dispatched. Under notification, we can have a view on what all is happening on the platform. So first, this says that a new order has been placed, a new customer has signed up, and a scheduled order has arrived. And then under update billing info, design your website and laundry stores, these are the heads which I'll show you. under different heads in demonstrations. So under reports you can see 3 heads: orders, laundry stores and customers. I have selected a date range which says from January 2 to 8th January. So here we can see that on 3rd of January there has been 12 orders on the platform and then the performance has dropped. So this will show you a brief about the orders. Then once you click on laundry stores, you can see that how many stores have registered on what dates, and same goes for the customers. So again on 3rd January, 2 customers signed up. Moving forward, so once we click on marketplace and followed by design, here we can design the layout for the customer facing application or the website. So you can customize the look for your marketplace. You can select the primary banner image, homepage background, and you can decide the tagline or the theme color. And you can also upload the banner. So let's say I have created a banner which shows image, details of image, name, text, laundry store name and action. So under actions, if I click on edit, I can edit my existing banner or I can delete the existing banner. Then under visibility to the customers, we can decide that what information we want to share it with our customers. Show the laundry store phone numbers to the customers, we can enable or disable it, followed by laundry store detail page, customers to see the exact location on the map, and laundry store addresses to the customer. Under terminologies, we can change the terminologies on the basis of a different use case. And like here, I have changed the word product into services because this is a service marketplace. Moving further, if I click on notification, I can select what all notification I want on my dashboard as an admin or on application. So on admin dashboard, I have selected email and notification on order placed because once the order is placed on the platform, I want information over the email and notification. About new sign up and order reminder, I have just selected notification. And then application notification, this is for customers and you can decide these on the basis of events, emails, notification, and you can take actions as well. So let's say for order placed, a customer will receive an email and notification both. And from action button, you can edit this information and you can select the template whichever you want to have set for the email and the notification. Then moving forward, once you click on finance, you can decide the currency on which the marketplace will work. So I have selected USD and you can also select the decimal value to be accepted. So I have selected 2 as a decimal value. Under miscellaneous, I have added additional charges for delivery, which is $2. And even I have enabled the option called merchant-wise delivery, wherein I have decided that best-in-town laundry have to pay the customers who will order from best-in-town laundry will pay 5 as delivery charges, and I have enabled this. And others which are not, options which are not enabled, so they will pay standard charge for delivery, that is 2. And under taxes, you can add various taxes according to your state. So I have added service tax as 2%. So these taxes could be fixed or the percentage. Then moving forward, once you click on checkout, you can see the option first, which is tip. You can decide if you want to enable the tip option or you want to disable it, like I have enabled. So the minimum tip I have decided is $2 for per order, which is fixed. And then under cancellation, you can create a custom or predefined cancellation. Token delivery flow, it could be merchant to marketplace or customer, it could be merchant to the customer or customer to the marketplace. And then payment option. I have enabled cash on delivery, but we also have different payment gateways and online methods for the payment. And then under customer sign up, so once the customer will sign up on the platform, we have segregated into various sections. First is required fields for sign up. These are mandatory. What the email and the phone number of the person is mandatory while signing up. And if we want a customer to verify their login via email or OTP verification, we will enable this. So under sign up template, I have created a field called address so that I can segregate my customer on the basis of location. And if I want to mark it mandatory, I can, and I can then save it. Even we have an option for customers can log in via Facebook, Instagram or Google. User tag is a place where a user can define a tag for itself. So let's say there is a tag called dry cleaning. A customer wants a service for dry cleaning. So he or she will only see those laundry stores which have the tag of dry cleaning with them. Then we move forward to laundry store setup. So we can have an open sign up store, or we can ask custom field information during sign up. So here I have, you can also create custom fields if you want any specific information from a person who's signing up on the platform. And then moving forward on analytics. Under analytics, you can have real-time information that what all is happening on the platform, about the revenues, live customers on the platform, and live orders. And then you can also review your orders and revenues. So this says that on 3rd January, we have the maximum number of orders and revenue generated. And you can also download your information by clicking on monthly orders and revenue, and you can visualize, you can get an information or reload the page just for the information about the platform and what all is happening. Then moving forward, clicking on orders. So under orders, you can see 4 sections. First is orders which are pending, orders dispatched, completed and cancelled. So let's say if you want to edit pending orders, you will click on the order ID, and then you can click on edit details, and here you can edit the order. And these 4 different forms of order will give you information about the order ID, merchant, customer, scheduled time, payment method, which could be cash or online, then address, ratings, delivery mode and order status. Then laundry stores. So these are the merchants or laundry stores on the platform. So under laundry store, first you can add a laundry store. You need to write their name, the person, the name of the person, email, phone number, the name of laundry store, displayed address and the exact address for the store, serving radius. You can drop their logo, your logo here, and the banner image. And you can also click on the order ID and review the information about existing stores. Under configuration, you can see all the information from date-wise availability, time-wise availability, scheduling, slot intervals, buffer before time slot appears, slot time intervals to display, customer order service, days to display, email notification, order placed, so if you want an order placed via email notification, and workflow. You can edit the information about the store, existing store, and you can create a catalog here. So catalog is basically defining your services into different proportions. So if you provide wash services, wash and fold, iron, dry cleaning, premium clothes, and you can also decide the pricing by clicking on the further options. So the laundry store option gives you a view about what is the order ID of the store, what is the ID for the store, name of the store, address of the store, phone number, email, what is the rating given, what is the average of the ratings given by customers, are they active or not active, or maybe you want to block or delete the store from the marketplace. So let's say if I want to enable the store and customers should not see the store, I'll just disable the store from the marketplace. Moving forward on promotions. So promotion is basically giving discounts to your customers, which could be fixed or percentage. So for example, I have created different offers here, and let's see if I want to edit any existing one. So first you will decide the percentage discount you want to give or the flat discount. You will give a promotion code, a name, then a discount value. You will write a description. You also have to mention the starting date and the ending date of the promotion and how many users you want to allow for this specific code and what would be the minimum order and other settings as well. Then moving forward, you can see by clicking on customers, you can see the total customers along with their details on the platforms, like ID of the customer, name, email, phone number, registration date of customers. And by clicking on actions, you can edit, block or view. Let's say I want to edit the detail. I'll just click here and can edit the detail whichever I want to. Or if I click on the ID, I can see a detailed information about the customer along with the tag. Then under settings, once you click on account, you can view the information about the person who is owning the marketplace, who is the super admin for the account. From here, you can change the password and you can edit the details. So let's say if I want to edit details, I just click on edit and this window will appear. You can also select the time zone for your operations. And then you can decide the unit that in distance you want to select. It could be kilometers or mile. You can enable option for the orders to accept or reject. And once you click on applications, so basically API keys are the integration to other various platforms, or maybe you can also do integrations by using API keys yourself. You can also select languages. Apart from English, we have multiple languages like French, Arabic, Portuguese, etc. on the platform. You can select according to your regional language. Under billings, first you can see the plan you are using and then you can add your card details for the further deductions from your account. So now I'll show you that how to stop.